December 1997 in Chiapas, a county in southern Mexico, not far from San Cristobal, where tourists enjoy their stay. A group of local Indians try to get away from paramilitary troops who have burned down their village. December 23rd, in the wooden church of Acteal. When the photographer Carlos Suarez arrives, he only finds the clothes of the 45 children, women and men who were shot by paramilitary soldiers the day before. The park of Chapultepec, Mexico City. A Sunday in April 1999, competing with the inevitable street traders, a Danish sculptor, together with a Latin American theater group, tries to draw people's attention by erecting a sculpture. The pillar of shame, or in Spanish, columna de la infamia, has been shipped all the way from Denmark to Mexico. It is erected as a monument in memory of a massacre in an Indian village in Chiapas in 1997. The pillar of shame is 8 meters high, weighs several metric tons, and is made of concrete. It is created by the Danish sculptor Jens Galschiot, and he has intended it to be a kind of a Nobel Prize in crime. Another pillar of shame was erected in Hong Kong in 1997 as a monument in memory of the student demonstrants who were massacred by the Chinese army in Beijing. It is the intention of the artist that 10 more sculptures will be placed all over the world where human rights have been violated.
At lave en række skulpturer, som jeg vil placere rundt omkring på kloden, ligesom markere bestemte begivenheder. Man kan sige, at stille ind i Hong Kong, bare på den ene side af kloden, som markerer demokratibevægelsens udvikling i kommunistiske lande, og hvad der sker med dem, hvad det er for nogle konsekvenser, det har, når man laver overgreb på demokratiske bevægelser. Så stiller jeg ind i Mexico, som kan man sige, det handler om de oprindelige befolkningens rettigheder. Bagefter stiller jeg en i Brasilien, som handler om jordløse landarbejders rettigheder, altså kampen omkring jorden. Og senere hen stiller jeg en i hjertet Europa, i Berlin, sammen med korsetfangerne, som handler om, at produktet, et af produkterne ved vores civilisation er fascisme. Og på den måde vil jeg de næste 10 år sætte en række pinde stikke en række pinde ned i jordkloden, så på en eller anden måde kommunikere med hinanden og sige, de her begivenheder har noget med hinanden at gøre. Det er noget med nogle beslutninger om at bruge vold som kommunikationsmidler. Det er noget med beslutningerne om at, at udradere folk for at nå sine mål. Og hvis man gør det, så har det nogle helt bestemte konsekvenser internt i landene.
Mexico City, the capital of a country that likes to compare itself with Western democracies, even though one single party, the PRI, has ruled the country since 1929, even though corruption and political violence is a part of everyday life, and even though estimation says that 70% of the population lives under the UN subsistence level. To 30 million people crammed together in a pulsating, stinking, noisy city where extremes meet between the uncomprehensible rich and the uncomprehensible poor. A city where beggars and armed guards occupy their regular places at nearly every street corner every single day. Mexico City, 1st of May, 1999. A group of Zapatistas from the jungle of La Candona in southern Mexico has traveled thousands of kilometers in order to join the 1st of May demonstrations and to be present when the Pillar of Shame, La Columna de la Infamia, is erected in front of the Mexican Parliament. The Zapatistas, who have named themselves after the Mexican hero of liberty, Emilio Zapata, fights for fundamental rights for the Indian population. They wear baklavas because, as they say, in order to be seen by the world, we need to cover our faces. The most powerful political bastions of the Zapatistas lie among the Indian population of southern Mexico, and they have not been active in the capital for many years. When they choose to be present, when the Pillar of Shame, an open accusation of the government and parliament, is to be erected, Jens Galschiøt hopes that this will finally make the sculpture the media event he had counted on it should be.
Man kan ikke forestille sig noget mere centralt end at stille den her på Zuccaloen i Mexico City, lige foran parlamentet. Og det gjorde vi så, stillede den op lige midt i det der ulovligt og alt muligt. Og tænkte så, nu er den der, nu kører den rent pressemæssigt, nu fungerer den her kommunikationsmæssigt, som den skal gøre. Men det gjorde den heller ikke, det blev næsten værre. Sjovt nok blev det næsten værre, at det var åbenbart så meget provokatorisk, at vi stillede den op der, at der var mange aviser, der ikke skrev om det. På trods af, at zapatisterne kom direkte fra La Candona-junglen og stillede sig op i kreds rundt omkring skamstøtten, så man må nok sige, at det var den bedste historie i Mexico den dag i hvert fald. Men mexikansk censur fungerer ikke på den måde, at man siger, at det må I ikke skrive. Men aviserne ved godt, at hvis de skriver noget helt bestemt, så kan de bare lige pludselig ikke få papir. Lige pludselig er der ingen, der kører deres aviser ud, osv. osv. Det er den måde, det fungerer på.
took our fruits. They removed our branches. They burnt our trunk. But they cannot kill our roots. This is written on one of the sheets of the Pillar of Shame, signed by the CNI, the Organization of the Aboriginal Population. The CNI cooperates with Jens Galschiot in the erection of the Pillar of Shame in Mexico. Mexico City, even though it was placed there without a permission. Nobody knows yet where it is to be placed for good. Only that it is going to travel south to Chiapas, where the Indian population for years and years has been victim of assaults and encroachments. A marketplace in San Cristobal, Chiapas, May 1999. Indian women still come on foot with their goods from the surrounding villages. The standard of living in Chiapas is the lowest in Mexico. Chiapas is no barren, poor region. On the contrary, one finds many natural resources in Chiapas, but the social structure reminds most of all of feudal Europe. On the one hand, rich cattle kings and planters of European origin. On the other hand, a penniless Indian population. Many of them don't speak Spanish and had very little schooling. 6,000 families own half of the land in the country, which population counts 3.5 million. 94 of the 111 municipalities are classified as extremely poor, and the insanitary conditions among the Indian population is compared with third world countries like Cambodia or Ghana. On the other hand, there is a considerable military presence. 70,000 governmental troops are stationed in Chiapas. Place in the jungle of La Candona in the south of Mexico, 7th of May 1999. A Danish sculptor and a Latin American theater group are stopped by the Mexican army for the seventh time on their way from San Cristobal to the village of La Realidad, where they are meant to join in a meeting that is arranged by the Zapatista movement.
Jens Galschiot. Danish.
Only one single road leads to La Realidad, where the meeting is set. It is loaded with military posts who check every single traveler.
Så jeg havde fået at vide, at Chiapas var infureret af 70.000 militærbetjente, der var alle vejen, eller militæret alle vejen, så det forbavsede mig ikke, da vi blev stoppet. Jeg synes, det var ubehageligt at blive fotograferet og skrevet op, og sådan noget. På den anden side var jeg også skrevet op i alle aviser i forvejen, så det generede mig egentlig ikke, og det var jeg også lidt vant til fra Hongkong. Så egentlig var jeg ikke nervøs. Altså jeg var godt klar over, hvad det skulle bruges til det der. Alle de der militære checkpoints bliver brugt langt hen ad vejen til at chikanere folk ud og registrere dem, og hvem kommer hvad, og hvad laver de, osv. Så, så jeg mener, det bliver brugt til at chikanere folk. Jeg føler mig ikke personligt troet. Jo, der var en gang, hvor vi holdt på et tidspunkt lige, hvor vi skulle ind til Acteal, hvor vi holdt i mange timer. Og der synes jeg, det var ubehageligt, også fordi vi stod i overhængen af det der, de har skabt det skimpestol, der stod rundt omkring nakken på en, ikke? Og det synes jeg, det var ubehageligt. På den anden side var jeg klar over, at hvis der var en af dem, der var kommet til at trykke af, så var det en fejl. Altså, der er ingen fare for, at jeg bliver skudt som billedhugger. Det vil være en katastrofe rent PR-mæssigt for dem, jo. Jeg skulle være nervøs for de folk, der er, altså for indianerne. Det er jo dem, der er på den. Det er jo dem, der bliver skudt. Det er dem, der bliver slagtet. Og det er menneskerettighedsforkæmperne. De meksikanske. Det er dem, der bliver slæbt ud på den anden landvej og banket ihjel.
Reality. La realidad. An autonomous village. Governed by the Zapatistas. The huge group of visitors, some of them from Europe, who are going to participate in a meeting of Indian organizations and sympathizers, are searched for weapons and liquor. After all those military points on the way, it feels irritating being checked once more. But one quickly finds out that the baklavas and the military appearance is merely symbolic. The Zapatistas are a rebel movement, but they have not fired a single shot or exploded a bomb since they, in January 1994, armed with machetes and old rifles, occupied the town hall of San Cristobal. Their demands were land and freedom for the Indian population. After a short and bloody confrontation with the army, 7 soldiers and 500 Indians were killed. The Zapatistas fell back to the jungle. Here they have since worked with peaceful means for political influence. The Zapatistas wish for the Indians to be able to keep their cultural character, among other, the collective ownership of property and ways of production. This is in obvious conflict with government plans for an opening of Chiapas to foreign capital and development of the region as industrialized county.
Aquí estoy detrás de mi nariz, bohemio renegado sin destino, disidente como un equívoco, un error, un loco, un transgresor, un mal parido, con los puños apretados, con la cara endurecida.
A Sunday morning in the La Candona jungle near the village of La Realidad. Francisco Vega sings a song about being an outsider, an undesirable person in the eyes of those who have the power.
En esta nube gris, con tanta necedad, echando chispas, exiliado en el descaro de vivir. Un tumor maligno en tu sonrisa. Verás que no estoy solo, somos muchos los proscritos, los bastardos, los malditos. Y estoy aquí, oculto en el rincón de lo prohibido. Pensando en ti, tratando de ser otro, pero el mismo. Insurrecto perseguido, ilegal y fugitivo, tengo un sueño clandestino para ti.
La realidad, 8th of May, Jens Galschiot and the translator from Danish meet with representatives of CNI, an umbrella organization for the Indian people. Jens Galschiot and his pillar of shame have now been in Mexico for a month. He decides that CNI shall make out where the sculpture is now to be placed.
Ja, det begyndte jo var, at den skulle stilles op i Acteal, men dem i Acteal skal lige holde møde først. Til syv lige nu, så skal den til Acteal at stå. Så, og alle de her folk kommer fra hele Mexico, alle Mexicos oprindelige folk rundt omkring, har delegeret for dem. Så Så man må sige, at den er blevet dybt forankret nu her, det sted, hvor den skal forankres.
of May 1999, a theater group from Argentina performs in the village of Acteal, a three-hour drive from San Cristobal in the county of Chiapas. Most of the spectators are Tzotzil Indians who have come to Acteal as refugees, driven out from their own villages by paramilitary groups. Acteal and the surrounding villages are today mostly inhabited by refugees, not from Guatemala or other neighbor countries, but Mexican Indians from Chiapas. They are driven away from their land by the paramilitary, operating with tacit agreement from the military and the government. Chiapas' natural resources are planned to be open for foreign companies which are interested in natural gas, crude oil and wood. Any Indian opposition to the government party PRI and their developmental policies is suppressed by paramilitary activities.
Los indígenas identifican quiénes son los paramilitares, saben que tienen armas, no están presos todos los acusados por la masacre de Acteal y el gobierno ha tolerado la permanencia de estos grupos armados, aunque lo niega oficialmente. Se les ve protegidos por la seguridad pública, por el mismo ejército circulando, no se hace nada contra ellos y entonces eso causa mucha extrañeza y mucho sufrimiento a estas comunidades indígenas.
The Jesuit priest Pedro Arrigas, who works in the villages surrounding San Cristobal, estimates that there are about 10,000 internal refugees in the area. There is much of disease and malnutrition in the villages and much need for humanitarian help. But the government does not acknowledge the problem. The refugees are therefore dependent on help from the International Red Cross.
Bueno, las razones fundamentales es porque están dentro del conflicto político social y razones de seguridad. Por ejemplo, hay un catequista que fue amenazado de muerte en Los Chorros, que tuvo que salir de su casa, refugiarse aquí, se quedó su esposa y sus hijos, y luego a la esposa la quisieron extorsionar, pedirle una suma de dinero de 10,000 pesos y no la amenazaban de muerte, y tuvo que ir la Cruz Roja, voluntarios del Centro de Derechos Humanos para sacar a esta persona y su familia. Entonces, por la falta de seguridad, por la amenaza de muerte, por las presiones políticas en esta guerra de baja intensidad, es por lo que se ha tenido, han tenido que salir de sus hogares los desplazados.
Acteal, 10th of May. Drums accompany another erection of the Pillar of Shame. More than 500 Indians have come to see the sculpture find its place where it belongs, on the scene of crime of one of the most bloody Indian massacres of recent Mexican history. In the memorial mortuary in Acteal, the sisters Rosa and Vera Capote and Lucia Ruiz, who do not speak Spanish but Tzotzil, tell how they lost their parents, brothers and sisters. On 22nd December 1997, paramilitary troops surrounded the small wooden church in the middle of a service. The girls only survived the subsequent shower of bullets because they lay under those who were killed first. All in all, 45 men, women and children were killed that day.
Esta iglesia, aquí estaban orando, rezando entre hombres y mujeres y niños para pedir la paz, para pedir una vida para el pueblo de México. Pero los priistas no quisieron respetar la iglesia, sino que fueron rodeados, disparando al aire, que ellos estaban armados con cuernos de chivos, metralletas, R-15, AK-47 y rifles automáticos, que le llaman la máscara roja.
Antonio, the spokesman for the inhabitants of Acteal, was working in San Cristobal, as were other men, on the day when the paramilitary groups came to the village.
Con tanta gente, aproximadamente como 200 paramilitares que vinieron disparando al aire en contra del EZ, en contra de nosotros, porque no quieren que nosotros vamos a trabajar así por vía pacífica, por vía respeto, por vía del diálogo, sino que lo que quieren ellos es acabar completamente con la gente indígena para que la tierra que se queda vacía, para que fácilmente pueden entrar a los extranjeros, a los ricos, a los más que son amigos del presidente Ernesto Zedillo, entonces es lo que piensan. Pero como nosotros, si nos dejamos que nos lleguen a invadir nuestra tierra, pues no tendríamos ni la vida para...
Den kamp, som de folk arbejder med rundt omkring, i både i Hongkong, men også i Mexico, den er livsfarlig, den er livstruende for dem. Og de prøver selvfølgelig at bringe sig de bedst mulige positioner på den ene eller anden måde, for at få det her diskuteret, for at få det offentliggjort, hvordan de har det, og få deres idéer frem. Det er jeg med til at hjælpe dem med. De ved godt, at det er farligt. Lige efter vi tog afsted, fra San Cristobal, var der en af dem, vi havde været sammen med, som blev slæbt ud på den anden vej og blev slået ihjel. De ved godt, at den her fare eksisterer. Det er ikke på grund af mig. Man kan sige, måske er det i virkeligheden på grund af mig og de europæere, der er dernede, at det ikke er gået værre til. At det ikke sker tiere. Vi er, os i Vesten, er os, der har magten på kloden. Det vil være dumt at bilde os andet ind. Indianerne som sådan er meget svage og meget spredte. Deres eneste chance er at alliere sig med folk i Vesten, progressive folk i Vesten, der siger, at deres kamp er væsentlig, deres kamp er rigtig. Det er deres overlevelsesmulighed.
Acteal, 10th of May. Hundreds of Indian refugees and a few photographers from international news agencies are waiting for the Pillar of Shame to be erected in order to demonstrate yet another crime. But in the course of the evening, the crane breaks down and the Pillar of Shame does not stand erected until the next day in the village of Acteal, where 45 unarmed men, women and children were killed on the 22nd of December 1997.
Aquí voy en esta nube gris, con tanta necedad, echando chispas.
Later, Thursday, 11th of May, on the way from Acteal to San Cristobal, Jens Galschiøt is stopped at yet another checkpoint. His passport is confiscated and he is summoned to an inquiry with the immigration authorities. 3 days later, Friday, the 14th of May, the Danish sculptor is questioned about his activities in Mexico. The inquiry ends with the confiscation of Jens Galschiøt's visa and the demand that he has to leave the country.
Tratando de ser otro, pero el mismo. Insurrecto perseguido, ilegal y fugitivo. Tengo un sueño clandestino para ti.